Hey guys, it's W from EDK Media. Thanks for coming back to the channel. Today, we have another tutorial. This time, it's on a software called WinX DVD Ripper Platinum. As you guys know, I did a series on burning movies using Make MKV and Handbrake. Well, that's all well and good when it comes to burning DVDs, Blu-rays, and at a movie level. But when you have a TV series, not so much. So this software that I came across, this is a non-sponsored video, by the way, completely handles that. It makes it completely simplistic. I tell you, it's fantastic. So I'm gonna show you how to use it and I'll leave the decision up to you. Let's get started. Okay, so literally this is a real simple process. So I did it, and now we're gonna run through the video real quick, and then I'm gonna stop and start it as we're going through some of this dialogue, just to make sure that you capture all the details, okay? So first of all, nice clean interface. Not much to this. It's very simplistic. Right out of the download and installation, there isn't anything you have to do to configure this. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to put the destination in. So wherever you want this to take the DVD. Oh, by the way, this is DVD Ripper Platinum. So it only works with DVDs. Doesn't work with Blu-rays, but most TV series, they're all on DVD. Like this one here for Young Sheldon. This is what I'm going to use. We just got it, season 5, and it's a DVD. And we have season 1 through 5. Haven't figured it. We haven't done season 6 yet, but I'm sure it's going to be just as good. Then after that, then we're going to go and we're going to click on disk, and you got to have an actual disk drive. So you put the DVD in there, just like you did before, and you're going to click on DVD. Now it's going to read the drive. It's going to show you exactly what the drive it is. Again, audio detection. You don't have to do anything with force UDF or force ISO. You don't have to worry about any of that stuff. Just stick it in there and then click on okay. And it's going to run it. So right out of the box, it's going to turn it into an MP4 video. I'll show you some of the other stuff that the software can do after this part. But we're just going to, again, leave it just the way it is. And then we're going to click OK. Now, once we do that, all of the episodes, they're about 20 minutes long. So this one up here that shows 3 hours and 33 minutes, that's the total. We don't want that, so we'll uncheck that. Down here at the bottom is less than a second. We'll uncheck that. We won't do that either. But we want to go through title 2 down through title 12. I'm just going to check all of those. You don't have to do anything over here. So again, Intel, NVIDIA, this is just looking at what type of video card that you have. You don't have to touch anything. You don't have to change the number of cores that you're using or the interlacing, none of that. And we're just going to go ahead and we're going to click run. Big blue one. And now it's going to start, and it won't stop until it's finished, but it'll go through title 2, title 3, title 4. So I accelerated this for you so that we could not have to wait for all 12 episodes. Go get a cup of coffee, go do something different, come back when you're all finished, and then you'll see this where it says all jobs complete. Now, I did disc 1 and disc 2. That's what it came with. You could see it puts it in here as season 5 disc 1, and then it starts disc 2. That way you won't have to rename anything. But I'm going to show you now is another software that I did another video on called FileBot. FileBot's pretty cool because it renames all of your files exactly the way you want them to, so that when you do add them to your PLEX server, it's going to pull in all of the metadata automatically for you, and you won't have to worry about that. So let me show you how that works. All right, so let me go down here and get FileBot. I encourage you guys, watch the video. It's a nice short tutorial. You'll love FileBot. It's very, very inexpensive. So from here, all you're going to do is you're going to grab these. We're going to copy and paste them, drag them over, and pop them in to the original file section. Then we'll go into episodes. And from episodes, we're just going to type in Young Sheldon or whatever the name of the video is. And then from here, you just click find. Now it's going to go through and it's going to pull in. There you go. Then you click on Young Sheldon. Click select. All right. Now, this is showing you all seasons. Well, we don't need all seasons. All we need is season 5. So we're going to go through and we're going to select season 5. And from here, then we're going to click on rename. So this is going to grab all of them for season 5, and it's going to throw them over into the rename bucket. So let's go ahead and do that. Now from here, again, this is where you put them. This is what you want to rename them to. And then watch how quick this is. So after I hit the rename button, I want your eyes to be over here and watch how this renames everything. Boom. Now everything's done. Now the great thing about this, we're good to go. We can go watch season 5. So that's it, gang. Again, very, very quick tutorial on WinX DVD Ripper Platinum. I will put a link in the description on where you can go for that. Additionally, I wrote a blog, nice little review. I'll put that in the description too. If you're interested, click on that. You can read a little bit more about the benefits of the software. Again, very, very simple. And there's also a couple other links to help you go out and get this if you choose to. I recommend it. Again, you've seen how quickly it was. We got it all done, and it only took us a couple seconds. Thanks, gang. I appreciate you coming back to the channel. I appreciate that you like the content, a lot of great comments. Do me a favor, put some more comments down there on any questions that you might have. And also, if you would consider subscribing to the channel, it's a little thing for you, big thing for us, trying to get to 1,000 subscribers, and we can do it with your help. Thanks again, and as always, stay safe and stay healthy. Take care, everybody. We're going through the process. I told you that I would show you the other configurations and the other things that you can do with WinX DVD Ripper Platinum. So that's what we're gonna do right now. To get to this section here, you have to have your DVD inside of the player. You have had to go through the first step of selecting DVD, so it reads it. And then it gives you the choice of what the outcome or the output of the profile is. Remember I told you about that? Normally it just goes right to the MP4 video. So from here, a couple different things you can do here. One is you can change from low quality to high quality. So this software actually compresses the video also, which in the previous videos that I did, you needed to use Handbrake to compress the video. Well, this does it all at one shot, which is what's even nicer about the software. And I always keep it right in the middle so it doesn't degrade the quality of the video. So from here, you can just grab the little bar and you can slide it to the left or to the right. Again, we'll put it back to the middle. And then you can go look at the profiles. Now, these are all the output profile categories. So you can change it to AVI. You can change it to be viewed on an iPhone or an iPad or an Android device, an MPV file. You can go into full backup mode. So you can copy and save a DVD with selected audio or video tracks. You can go directly into the specific devices that you're going to be using, from Android pad to mobile, Microsoft, Sony devices. I mean, this is pretty universal type software. So, you know, the versatility is really good. I'll just keep scrolling down. You guys can take a look at these. And again, general video. The other part behind this is that you can go directly into and configure the format. So right now it's set for MP4, but you can see here where you can pick the decoder. You can change your frame rates and your bit rates. I don't see why you would need to do that. Again, I've been using this software now for a few months, and I've never had to make any adjustments before allowing the software to do what it likes to do. Frame rate, creep original, resolution. You can take it all the way down to 1080p if you want to, or 720. I think most DVDs are in 720. Again, I keep everything original, but you can change it. And then when you're done, you just click OK. The other thing that you can do, you can go into your options. And in your options, you can go ahead and pick your default language. You can also open the output folder upon completion. That's what I have mine set at. So you've actually seen that, where as soon as we were finished, it popped open the file. And then you can also set your output and your snapshots. So that's pretty much just your default, so it automatically goes into the right one. Now if you change it, if you're doing a series, then you're gonna have to change it for each one of those output folders. You can send emails. More than 95% of questions from our users can be found on the help file. If you don't find it, you can always send them an email. I've done that and they get back pretty quick. It says within 24 hours. And if your question is, did you have any issues with it? I had no issues with the software. I just sent them an email to see if they responded within 24 hours. And then the other piece is setting your tags. So we'll stop here for a minute. You can see how the target name and what it's going to be set to. You can change any of this if you'd like to and apply it to all of the series. Again, I don't do any of that. So as you can see, everybody, the software gives you a lot of nice settings and things that you can configure if you choose to. I'm solely utilizing this for my TV series. It makes it 10 times easier. I haven't found a software that is this simple to use. Anyone can. If you're interested, down in the description you'll find a link. I wrote a nice short blog, tells you a little bit about the benefits. Please give it a click. A lot of cool information, takes you to more of our video collection. And thank you again. I hope you enjoy the video. Until next time.